foreign investment to South Africa.
We do not need foreign direct investment in South Africa in order for the South African economy to prosper. South Africa has got resources. South Africa has got everything that it needs to grow. We only need political will, and we only need the ingenuity and the hard work of our people. But for any policies like expropriation of land to happen, we only need South Africa to retrace its roots, because we know that we are scared that any time we start implementing policies that are in the interest of black people of this country, we are always scared of an onslaught or terrorist activities from white monopoly capital and foreign direct investment. So any time that the country or any time that black people start to organize, come together to reclaim the economy and implement policies that will ensure that black people are not excluded from the economy, there's uncertainty in the market. All of a sudden, foreign direct investment is threatened. So that is the contradiction that we have today. If we don't address this contradiction, we will forever be enslaved to a narrative that seems to suggest to us that if we expropriate land, if we give our people back their dignity, then we are going to scare away foreign investors. Remember that South Africa is South Africa because of the Berlin Conference. So all the artificial borders you see around us are a creation of the Berlin Conference in 1884 to 1885. So we have to be sure that we have enough black people in Africa to support us the moment we divorce our marriage with foreign direct investment. Because Africa is able to trade amongst itself. Inter-Africa trade is the future of South Africa. We have the market. Remember that black people have power, and this power comes from our power as consumers. In order